What specifically in commercial cloud doesn't meet CMMC L2 requirements? Again, a question we get all the time, right? As a Microsoft government cloud partner, CMMC L2 controls can be implemented in commercial. Okay. I feel like people would just take that little snippet of me saying that and then just start circulating that around the internet, and that would be the end of it, right? However, like we talked about before, CMMC and NIST control frameworks, okay? DFARS 7012, which is the one that's been around as we know it today since 2016, 2015, cannot be met because of the incident response requirements. This is the gotcha, right? The gotcha is paragraph C through G of your DFARS 7012 requirement. So people ask all the time, Daniel, if we're doing CMMC, do we even got to worry about DFARS, right? If you look at the CMMC level 2 guidance, right, the control map, it's just the NIST 800-171 controls, right? Or practices versus controls. But you just look, and it's the same 110. It doesn't say anything about clouds or FedRAMP or anything like that. And you, my friend, are correct. However, CMMC assessment process, the CAP, as they call it, assessors are supposed to be reviewing and making sure that you're meeting those requirements for your cloud providers. Just when you think you could get around not having to do DFARS 7012 and meeting those extra things like incident response or FedRAMP, CMMC said, not so fast. When we come and assess you, we're also going to have to take a look at those things. So you're not going to dodge a bullet. You can look at the CMMC assessment process yourself, publicly available document on the Cyber AB's website.